Dear students, once again I am here, Lalit Kumar P. Bhaiya, Associate Professor, Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering Department, Bharati College of Engineering and Technology, Durg. Dear students, today we will learn about the analog electronics. But before going to this particular topic, I would like to tell you that you have already gone through the various articles, various units of the analog electronics. And I hope you are already aware with the topics which I am going to discuss now. But this topic I have taken once again because of the importance of the topic. This is frequency response of RC coupled amplifier. You know, in multi-stage amplifier, there are various cascading stages. Number of stages are cascaded with a different types of coupling between the two stages. And these two stages coupling are maybe RC coupled, transformer coupled, direct coupled. Or it may be an emitter follower stage. So here, today we will discuss about this RC coupled amplifier, RC coupling between the two stages. You can see here this transistor 1 and this is the transistor 2. You can say this is first amplifier stage, this is some second amplifier stage, and this is called as RC coupling. Here RL is there and this coupling capacitor CC. Similarly, here RL is there and finally we will take the output. So come to this first stage. This is called as a first stage here. This one is the first stage which I am showing by a block here. This is first stage amplifier in which voltage divider is used as a biasing. That is R1 and R2 are the voltage divider. RL is the load, RE is the emitter resistance and CE is the bypass capacitor for this emitter. And CC is the coupling capacitor. That's why it is called as RC coupled. In similar way, this transistor T2 forms the second stage with R1 and R2 voltage divider. RL is the load, RE is the emitter resistance, and CE is the bypass capacitor. And this is the output, and input is this VS is the source voltage, and RS is the source resistance, which is also coupled to the input through this coupling capacitor, that is input capacitor. So this is two stage RC coupled amplifier. Now why these two stage RC coupled amplifier are used? To get the large bandwidth. Within a large bandwidth we will get a flat response, good response in a large bandwidth. You can see here, this is the characteristics of the RC coupled amplifier. Here this type of characteristics you will get here. This is the overall gain of the amplifier. Output upon this input is the overall gain. This is the midband gain. This is called as midband gain. And this gain is the 3 dB lower gain. This is called as 0.707 times AV max. This is 3 dB lower. So at 3 dB lower gain or 0.707 times AV of the midband, we will get the two frequencies, called as a lower cutoff frequency and higher cutoff frequency. And the difference between these two frequencies is called as bandwidth. So what I was saying earlier, that to get the large bandwidth, we will get the flat response. This is the main achievement of this RC coupled amplifier. Hence, this RC coupled amplifier is very important. Today we will go the one more numerical also. In this RC coupled amplifier, here you can see RO dash is equal to 1 upon HOE parallel to RL. So RO dash is equivalent diagram. You can see here, this is the input current source, HFE into IP, because this is common emitter configuration in both cases. So this is HFE into IP, and the overall output resistance of the first stage here you can say RO dash. So this RO dash you will get here, and RI dash is the overall input impedance of the second stage. This is RI dash. So So RO dash is the this overall output resistance of the first stage, and RI dash is the overall input resistance of the second stage. So this is the basically equivalent circuit, and this coupling capacitor in between these two CC, RO dash, and this is RI dash. So we can write this current source HFE into IV parallel to RO dash and parallel to RI dash. Now this RO dash can be calculated with the help of this formula, 1 upon HOE parallel to RL. 1 upon HOE means it is a admittance of common emitter in terms of the H parameter. So 1 upon HOE, that means output admittance, or in terms of, you can write output resistance, parallel to RL. This is equivalent RO dash, and RI dash is equal to, you can see here, this R1 and R2. When we go through the H parameter model, these two comes in parallel. So R1 parallel to R2 and parallel to this RI2. RI2 means the input impedance of the second stage. So this is RI2 here, parallel to R1, parallel to R2. When we ground this VCC and we have only input, then R1 parallel to R2, parallel to RI2. So this is RI dash, R1 parallel to R2, parallel to RI2 is the RO dash. Once we get these two components from this equivalent diagram, AC equivalent diagram or low frequency H parameter model, you calculate these two values, RO dash and RI dash. Once again, I am telling you, RO dash is the output, total equivalent output resistance of the first stage, and RI dash is the total input equivalent resistance of the second stage. Now, from these two values, you can calculate the overall voltage gain of this mid-band gain. What is the voltage gain of this mid-band gain? This you have to calculate, AV mid. The formula for this AV mid is equal to minus HFE into IV into RO dash into RI dash upon RO dash plus RI dash into VI. VI is the actual input available to this input terminal. VI is the actual input available to this input terminal from the source. VS, from the VS we will get the VI here. Whatever is the VI, we will get here. And this is VI. So this AV midband gain, this midband gain you can calculate from this formula. AV mid is equal to minus HFE. HFE is the forward current gain of the common emitter source, common emitter amplifier, into IV, RO dash into RI dash upon RO dash plus RI dash into VI. So once you get this AV midband gain, then you can also calculate the lower cutoff frequency, that is FL. Here you can say this lower cutoff frequency is shown by this FL. So you can calculate the value of FL, which is given by 1 upon 2 pi CC into RO dash plus RI dash. 1 upon 2 pi into CC into RO dash plus RI dash. So this formula is important for RC coupled amplifier. This formula is important AV midband gain for RC coupled amplifier. And this you can calculate from the circuit diagram. The given diagram, you can calculate this RO dash and RI dash. So this is the characteristics of the RC coupled amplifier. So these are the important things while describing the RC coupled amplifier. And this is one of the practical is also there in analog electronics to determine the frequency response of the RC coupled amplifier. So similar type of circuit will be there in practical. You have to change the frequency, change the amplitude of this input source and see, keep the amplitude of this source is constant and change the input frequency from, let us say, supposed to be 10 Hz and change it from 10 Hz to supposed to be a 50 kilohertz and observe the output voltage. Mark the output voltage here and give the supply also VCC. Let us say supply is plus 5 volt or plus 7 volt. This supply is given, then apply the input here and change the in frequency of this input source from 10 Hz to 50 kHz. Change from 10 Hz to 50 kHz, observe the amplitude of this output voltage. then this amplitude of the output voltage upon amplitude of the input voltage, you will get the gain. And now plot this frequency versus this gain. You will get this type of characteristics. And from these characteristics, you can find out the bandwidth. So this is a very important article in case of the multi-stage amplifier, RC coupled amplifier, which is used in middle frequency ranges generally. For the low frequency range, there is no such effect of the low frequencies, then we can use the direct coupled amplifier. For middle frequency range, we can use this RC coupled amplifier. And for the impedance matching purpose, we can use the transformer coupled amplifier. Between these two stages, we use the transformer coupled. So this RC coupled plays a very important role in mid-band frequencies or mid-frequencies particularly. Neither lower nor higher frequencies, we can use this RC coupled amplifier. Now, dear students, on the basis of this formula which I have told you here, and according to this circuit diagram, RC coupled amplifier, I will give you one numerical here, and later on we will see the solution of the numerical. I have got this numerical here, so you go through this numerical. This type of numericals may be asked. I will rough this here and I will write the numerical. Later on we will see the solution of the particular numerical, because this is based on the particular topic, that is RC coupled amplifier. And rather than this numerical, there are lot of numericals are available in the various books and in my notes also. So you can go through these numericals also. This is a very simple numerical. This is the bandwidth of an amplifier is from 30 Hertz to 15 kilohertz. 30 Hertz to 15 kilohertz. Find frequency range over which AV is down by 0.5 dB from its mid-band value. Now, dear friends, this is the problem which is given to you, and I hope you understand this, what is given in the numerical problem. The bandwidth of an amplifier is from 30 Hertz. This is the lower frequency, and 15 kHz is the higher frequency. Find the range of over which AV is down by 0.5 dB. So what you have to do, you have to equate this 0.5 dB, that is down means lower. So AV at lower upon AV at mid-band, this ratio should be equal to minus 0.5, because it is down, so we will write the minus 0.5. So AV by, you can write here, magnitude AV at lower frequency upon AV at mid-band. This can be written as minus 0.5. Similarly, you can write also AV at higher frequency upon AV at mid frequency can also be written as minus 0.5. And from this, you can solve the numerical and find the frequency range, lower frequency range, and the frequency of the input when lower frequency range is considered, and frequency at the input when higher frequency range is considered. So this frequency is to be find out. So we will use the formula for the frequency range for this ratio, and we can calculate this f when fn is there, that is 30 kilohertz. We will calculate the f when fh is 15 kilohertz. So we will get a particular range. Are you understand now? Now you try to solve this problem. If not possible with you, I will tell you this problem with a complete solution in the next video, please. Or otherwise, you can ask me if you have any difficulties to solve this problem. You can ask me at any time on any platform. Either you can ask on WhatsApp or you can ask on phone also by calling me. Or you can ask if the college is running, then you can ask in college also and go through the such number of numericals also. Okay? Thank you. Thank you very much.